When most people think of the country of Singapore, they think of movies and extravagant parties like in Crazy Rich Asians, being destroyed on the second Independence Day, or its futuristic architecture from the third season of Westworld. But when I think of Singapore, I think of the country as the maritime capital of the world, with the second busiest port, aquaculture fish farming for food fish, amazing aquarium fish like koi, betta, and arowana fish, and finally, the diversity of cultures, people, and food. I just returned home from Singapore after visiting scientists from the National University of Singapore and from around the country to talk about aquaculture development. Singapore is on a mission to grow and supply 30% of its food by 2030 in an effort to have food security for a small island nation of almost 6 million people. While visiting, I was able to meet wonderful and generous people, tour several amazing fish farms, attend a tropical fish show, and present and learn at the World Aquaculture Society annual meeting. Oh yeah, and eat lots of seafood. One of my first activities was to take a ferry trip to St. John's Island to visit the Singapore Food Agency's Marine Aquaculture Center and the National University's Marine Laboratory. The MAC has more than 20 years of tradition in cultivation of Asian sea bass. Asian sea bass is also called barramundi. The facility conducts research on fish feeds. They recently built a new feed mill to supply their own fish culture and research, as well as partnering with university scientists from around the country. Besides studies on fish nutrition, they've been working with a number of other fish, such as pompano, marine tilapia, and red snapper. When working with marine fish, you better be good at larval culture. And to be good at larval culture, you best be great at microalgae and zooplankton farming to feed your fish larvae. After touring the MAC, I walked over to the St. John's Island National Marine Laboratory and hung out with Dr. Serena Teo and Dr. Yanni Tanzel. The Marine Laboratory is the only offshore scientific research laboratory in Singapore. Dr. Teo and I discussed traditional fish farming practices in Singapore versus the country's desire to move to more high-tech fish farming practices. One thing I noticed early on in my trip was all the discussions about high trophic aquaculture species. Now, if you are out and about and look at the variety of food options for lunch and dinner, you quickly realize that there is a diversity of low trophic aquaculture species eaten by native Singaporeans. People here eat two types of lobsters, shrimp, prawns, mussels, clams, oysters, cockles, and snails. I spent almost all my entire trip trying to find cockles and conch snails, the natives called gong gong. Dr. Teo promised to take me out for cockles and snails on Saturday. Dr. Yanni's background is in coral ecosystems, and while there wasn't a lot of research into subsistence farming, there was a number of interesting conservation aquaculture projects going on. I love this research on giant clams. They are a vulnerable species for extinction due to their popularity in the pet trade and coral reef degradation. Check out this amazing work on coral conservation. Now, this is a new type of three-dimensional vertical farming. What a clever use of Legos. It's a whole Lego city for ocean conservation. Tell me, this wagon wheel Lego construction isn't brilliant? B- Before leaving the island of St. John's, I got a good look at the new offshore net pens built for barramundi farming. On my return trip to the mainland, I couldn't help but think of all the multi-use challenges marine aquaculture has in this ocean environment. My next few days were a whirlwind of activity in which I was able to visit commercial aquaculture farms. I toured the Eco-Ark, perhaps the most incredible fish farm I have ever seen. I met some of Singapore's first offshore net pen fish farmers and learned how they continue to innovate and supply Singapore and other countries with seafood. On the way back for lunch after the net pen farm visit, I had no luck with the cockles and gonggong. Turns out it's mostly eaten for dinner. In Singapore, land-based marine recirculating aquaculture systems can also be found. I had a great chat with Kane at Atlas Aquaculture and learned how they manage their water. Singapore used to be the ornamental fish capital of the world, while land-based fish farms are shrinking due to competing interests such as the military and population expansion. Singapore remains a major hub for the tropical fish trade. I think my first love of fish keeping started with the arowana fish. So I was very excited to visit Gary and his daughter Guinevere on their Asian arowana farm. Asian arowana are a highly prized aquarium fish and called dragonfish in some cultures. They're now a CITES species and some of the most expensive and beautiful fish in the aquarium hobby. So after attending the World Aquaculture Society conference, I visited a tropical fish show at the convention center. I was able to see and hear the koi and betta fish being judged. I really have a new appreciation for these spectacular bettas. There was even an evaluation of aquatic turtles. Aren't they so cute? I'm not a big fan of koi and goldfish. In fact, I can hear the carp feeding and smell them when I close my eyes and think about all the time I've spent with carp. I had a great conversation with representatives from the Vermilion Goldfish Club of Singapore. These goldfish may not be the best swimmers, but the colors of the fish were stunning, and learning about how well these goldfish are cared for gave me a new appreciation for these fish. No, I won't have any goldfish in the future, but I really liked what these people were doing. Well, I was disappointed that I'm leaving tomorrow and I have yet to find any clams and snails. For my last night, a colleague and I went on an adventure looking for the seafood. After several failed attempts, we had one last stop to make. The Marina Bay Sands Hotel and Casino. And with 30 minutes until closing time, we finally had our cockles and gonggong. If you don't want to miss my Singapore fish farm tour videos, please like this video and make sure you are subscribed to my This Is Aquaculture channel. This is Dr. Jackson Gross.